By the way, my queen of the night is so much happier in the bathroom than she was in the living room, and I am just like so pleased. So pleased. You think you've got what it takes to be the best barista that you can be? Think you can be your customer's favorite? Are your shots the freshest? Your froth the creamiest? Your whipped cream mountain the most picturesque? Well, I'm here to whip your barista skills into shape. My name's Catherine. I'm a cool mom and also an ex-barista. And I want to make you the best barista that you can be. Whether you're a brand new green bean or a fully dark roasted bitter multi-year partner, I've got tips that'll make you the best barista that you can be. I've got some extensive notes here. Number one, know your recipes. Before you can even learn the techniques for how to make the beverage, you have to know what goes in the beverage. How many shots of espresso? How many pumps of syrup? How many pumps of frappe roast? What topping crowns your creation? All of these things have to be memorized. Yes, sorry to break it to you green beans, but you're gonna have to memorize every single beverage. Now, there's a couple of handy dandy charts out there that show you how many shots, how many pumps, etc., per size of beverage, and you'll start to see some correlations between drinks once you start learning the different recipes. Now, there are standouts like a misto, which don't follow any of those rules, but are one of the most simple beverages to make. Now, the easiest way that you can learn what goes into a beverage is by studying recipe cards. Your manager or your trainer can most likely show you where the stack of recipe cards lives in your particular store. If you can get your hands on this stack of recipe cards, use them like flashcards. In the beginning, you're gonna be standing at the register a lot, and any downtime that you might have can be used to study these recipe cards. Use those recipe cards as if they were flashcards. And what I mean by that is when you see the latte card, for example, think to yourself, a tall gets how many shots? One. Grande gets two shots. Venti gets three shots. Then you'll flip it over to the back and you'll see, oops, crap, Venti gets two shots of espresso, actually. You can learn how many shots of espresso and how many pumps of syrup go into each beverage. You should also be given a little notebook called like a coffee journal or something like that, coffee planner. You should be given one of those at the start of your training. If you're not given one, ask for one. Usually there's a giant stack sitting around somewhere in your store. Use the back of that little notebook and write down the cheat sheet chart that has all of your shots and pumps and type of milk and topping, etc., on it, and put it in your apron pocket. So that way, anytime you jump on bar, if you're unsure about what the drink is or what it contains, you can whip out your cheat sheet, look at it, learn the right information, and put it back in your pocket. And over time, you won't need it at all. It's just a security blanket. Using the recipe cards like flashcards will drill the recipes into your tiny little over-caffeinated noggin. And if for some reason you cannot find the recipe cards in your store, just Google Starbucks drink recipe cards, and you might have to print some out on your own or download a PDF that you can keep on your cell phone and look at whenever you get the opportunity. But this is honestly the best way to learn without actually being on bar. Tip number two, be excellent at your job no matter where you are on the floor. Now, of course, the bar is the most coveted position for most partners. But I mean, let's face it, if you're new, you're gonna be on the register and on the ovens for probably quite a while. You probably didn't go into your new job at Starbucks thinking that you were gonna be making warm croissants and ringing people up on the register for weeks on end, but you kinda gotta work your way up to being on bar. So while you're here working these positions, get to know and love them. Be excellent at these positions on the floor. Bar is really fun, but is also super stressful. Shit, the entire job is stressful no matter what you're doing. Once you get to the point where you are on bar and you're confident making drinks and you've done that for weeks on end after you're a seasoned partner, you're gonna relish the opportunity to jump back on the register for a few days or be positioned at ovens for a few days. It's refreshing because once you get really good at doing these jobs, you're gonna find a rhythm and a pace at it. You're gonna gain that confidence. Tip number three, get to know and love your customers. Yes, even the nitpicky ones. For most service industry jobs, your customers are your lifeblood. If you don't have customers in your store, then you don't have a store. If you spend just a few minutes with each person trying to get to know them, you'll start to see the same people multiple times a week. Write down their name, write down their order, and play a little game with yourself of trying to memorize these people and their drinks so that way when they come in and you greet them, it makes them feel really special. Then you can spend that time getting to know them and asking where they're going, where they came from, what they're up to, how have they been, that kind of thing. Eventually, once you get to know certain regular customers, they're gonna be the best part of your job because you're really gonna look forward to seeing these familiar faces coming in your store and you having the opportunity to chat with them every day. On the flip side, you're gonna have some not so great customers and that's gonna make you wanna lose faith in humanity. But thank the heavens for our awesome regular customers. I promise you, there are some customers that I really honestly look forward to seeing at my old job and I think about them sometimes and wonder what they're up to. Memory card was full. All right. Back to this. Even the customers who have the most particular and complicated drink orders, you need to come to think of as someone who is very, very dedicated to the brand and have taken a really long time ordering their drink multiple different ways to try to figure out how they like it. And they've put a lot of work and time and effort into customizing this beverage to get it just the way that they like it. So this type of order, even though it can be kind of annoying to take the order and annoying to make the drink, this person is valuable to your company and valuable to your store. And if you ask them how they came to get a drink so complicated, you might be interested to find out their reason why. I mean, you gotta love a person who knows what they want. Number four, when you do get on bar, challenge yourself to be faster, more precise, more perfect with each drink that you make. Starbucks is awesome because their drink system is standardized across most stores, which means if I get a grande peppermint mocha in Georgia and I get a grande peppermint mocha in New York, they're going to be the same beverage. The partners are going to be making the mocha syrup the same way. So when you make a drink, you're going to be making it the same way every single time you make it. Making drinks on bar, making any kind of espresso beverage, is a minor art form if you look at it. You're only going to get better if you challenge yourself to be better each and every day. Could that cappuccino's foam be foamier? Did you truly put your heart into making that drink as delicious as you could? Did you swirl the espresso in the mocha or did you forget? If you didn't make a drink as best as you could, don't beat yourself up. Just do it better next time. Every mistake is a learning opportunity. You gotta keep trying and keep getting better at what you do. Eventually, it's gonna become like second nature, like singing the ABCs. You're gonna get so good on bar and so confident and comfortable doing what you're doing that you can hold conversations with customers. You can coach other partners. You can juggle the next drinks that are coming up in the line while making beverages at the same time. It's gonna feel really good and the time is gonna fly by. It becomes fun, but first it has to get really uncomfortable and stressful while you're learning and while you're not so good at it. But push through that feeling of discomfort and on the other side, you're gonna be a badass barista. Tip number five for being the best barista you can be is keep your space tidy as you go. Put that carton of milk back into the fridge as soon as you finish using it. Rinse that pitcher or blender as soon as you finish pouring the drink into the cup. Rinse that spoon off and put it where it goes. Wipe up your countertops if they get gross. When you train yourself to get in the habit of quickly cleaning up after each beverage that you make, what you're doing is setting yourself up for success for the next beverage that you have to make. If all of your pitchers are filthy, if the milk caps are all over the place, If you don't know where your spoon is, if you haven't rinsed a lid or put the lid to the blender back where it goes, you're gonna feel really scattered on bar. Smoother you can transition from drink to drink, the better a drink-making master you're gonna be. Discipline yourself to put things back where they go while your hand is still on it, or clean things as you go while you're holding it. So that way you don't have to waste the effort of putting it down while it's dirty, doing some more stuff, and then coming back to it, pick it up again to clean it off and rinse it. It's easier to just pour the milk into the cup and immediately, while it's in your hand, rinse it off so that that way you can get on to the next drink quicker. Well, there you have it. Did you take any notes, green beans? Seasoned partners, did you learn anything new? Or do you disagree about some of my tips? Let me know in the comments below. Happy drink making. Don't forget to subscribe, please, if you liked this video, if you made it this far. Click on some of my other Starbucks related videos. Anyways, I'll see y'all in the next one, okay? Bye.